I've been doing Qigong for 30 years. Qigong has been in China for 7,000 years. It's a very, very old stuff. And the first form of a written Qigong was from the emperors called Da Yi. At that time, 4,500 years ago, he was the emperor, and he led his people to do a lot of amazing things to survive in the nature. So he had a lot of injuries, and he also had developed arthritis. But as a leader, he had to lead his people to do a lot of things, right? Because of his mobility, and he was not able to do that. So he developed a kind of a dance. Later on, this is called Yi dance. So, 9 steps, holding deep breath and walking towards to the sun or to the moon, doing the ceremony, and so 9 steps back slowly, and then move around. By doing so, he found this movement could help him to ease his pain. And then he did it more, and he helped himself to heal, to cure his arthritis. So that was the first written form of Qigong starting at that time. So after that, in the history, in the last 4,000 years and 4,500 years, a lot of scholars and doctors like Li Shizhen and many other doctors, and Ge Hong, and that's Chinese doctors' names, and got involved with this power of the movement and the mind and the spirit put together. And they found out, you know, this is so powerful. And then they slowly got this into the medical mainstream in China. Actually, Qi is the cornerstone of every modalities of healing in China. And then they discovered, wow, at the very beginning, they called this as a energy breathing exercise, or breathing guided activities, or inhaling, exhaling activities. So they have that name for it. And then later on, they found out the formation of the body is pretty much the same as that of the universe. At that time, when they said that the universe is, they mean the solar system, then they found out, wow, this is even much bigger, many times bigger than what they originally thought. So they couldn't find a proper name for this one. Because, for instance, you know, every year we have 365 days. Right? And in the body, we have 365 acupuncture points, the energy points. And in the body, we have 12 major energy channels. And then every year, we have 12 months. And each channel works 2 hours a day, and then passes the duty to the next one. And then so we have 24 hours a day, and then it forms a cycle. And then the body's operation with all these channels running on duty one after another, based on the movement of the sun, the movement of the moon. So now, even through meditation, they found out this meditation exercise, a simple movement, not only be able to affect your physical body, healing yourself with aches and pains, balancing the body in so many, from so many perspectives, it can also help you to affect the matters around. Like, for instance, your energy affects your dogs and cats, affects the plant. And lots of studies have shown that this energy in China, they have you call it the control groups. They have a Qigong people, the Qigong, the rice. And the rice with the Qigong, without, and comparing to the rice without Qigong, the taste and the quality of the rice is much better than that. They even use it to work on the apple trees. They found the meridians in the apple trees, and then they used the needles, the bamboo needles, and hammer it into those spots. They call it the meridians. And every year, these apples produce great apples. Instead of comparing to the other trees, one year is good, the other year is not good, right? So then, what is the proper name of this practice then? Well, finally, in the last century, at the 30th, Qigong, this word, got adopted. It's working with the energy. Qi is energy, Gong is work. Working with the energy in your body and in the environment. That is all Qigong about. You bring harmony inside the body, inside your around your environment. That can help you to balance the energy. Everything is about balance. If you can get yourself back to balance, then everything will be perfectly fine. Qigong has been practiced in China for 7,000 years. If something can last for 7,000 years, it gotta be good, right?
That's for sure.
That's number one. And then I got into Qigong, that's because of my illnesses. I grew up in China. So from very, very little, and I heard about Tai Chi and Qigong and martial arts, but Qigong is a very, at that time, it is still in China, it's very mysterious because people consider this as some very high level of masters sitting in the valley, meditating, flying from the top of the one hill and to the other every day, back and forth, and that kind of thing. Actually, that is not real. Qigong, it is a way you cultivate the energy from within to help yourself to heal your body completely and help you to gain back the balance.